The next talk is by Jordi Guijarro. Guijarro. And it's from private cloud to IaaS, public services for Catalan R&E community.
Okay. Thanks. Let's start with the session. Thanks for coming. And thanks for use OpenNebula, too. This talk is, we want to cover with this talk our experience about to construct and to pass for managing private clouds with OpenNebula to offer IaaS services to our community, research and education community in Catalonia. And let's start with this. It's only maybe innovate, imitate, imitate, innovate. I mean, it's two words that represents that with this kind of activities, we are not reinventing the wheel. We are doing, maybe, a real conversion, real change as IACP provider. Inside the agenda, we have some topics to cover, some questions at the end. Why cloud-oriented for CESUC, for Catalonia R&E agents? Why architecture? What we are providing, the kind of services, and how we squeeze hardware, survey details, myths and facts, some conclusions to finish. About the CSUC, we are the consortium, public consortium, that we are providing services to all the public and private universities in Catalonia, inside Spain, as you know. We've started this year, formerly known as CESCA. CESCA was the supercomputing center for Catalonia for 20 years, and now we have a new commit. All that you have been represented are our patterns that we are working together to build new services. And about our services now, we have a cloud of services that cover all the layers from the infrastructure, included the research and education network until the application layer. We are providing services with data repositories, with application of different ARPs for universities, and so on. It's only to be introduced, you have here in German, I did DFN. You have problems with my name, but I have problems with your NRIN in German. I don't know how to say DFN in German. It's, DFN is okay, but if you have to translate the acronym, no, if you have to, the acronym, you have to put names in German. DFN is the Deutsch for, okay, Guijarro. Okay. And well, we are managing the research and education network, regional in Catalonia. We are managing the internet change point of Catalonia, providing HPC services and providing digital repositories and applications. Okay? And all of these services need infrastructure. Our approach, cloud-oriented. As CSUC, we offer two data center services. This is the baseline scenario. It's about a typical housing model with sysadmins that manage these physical and virtual servers. We have a target scenario, is to have a virtual data center service in a hybrid model, in hybrid, providing hybrid solutions to our community. Remember, our community, it's a community that have his own IT, his own IT personnel, and maybe it's large, in some cases, than CSUC. We're talking about universities that provide this service to about 75,000 students, some of them. About the infrastructure evolution, we have to take care, and we are aware that we have this evolution. And now, it represents that we are here, that we have to combine public and private resources, if we're talking about infrastructure. But maybe there is here an opportunity to change the new or the hardware managed model for our community. Okay? And maybe with this kind of service, we can change the way to make things with infrastructure in home, outside home, inside the public cloud, inside the CSUC public cloud, and so on. For us, we have to, why we want to have this change? As ICT service provider, as always, ever, we have specific needs for science and education environments, new specific needs. We need a data center service evolution and be aligned with a pay-per-use model. In this case, CSUC is a public consortium, but CSUC, it's different. Maybe it's different for the research agents that we are providing these kind of services, because our users pay for the services. Each service has price. Okay? It's important to understand this model. About the technical challenges, new knowledge, expertise in new technologies. For technicians, always. We need this kind of challenge. We have and to design and development of new system architecture, we have to change the past. For this, you know, we have different options to orchestrate this infrastructure. And this is a slide that we have seen a lot of times. Why not OpenStack for CSUC directly? I think that this slide represents the main way to be aligned is to replace our common virtualization architectures or platforms to a new stage, driven by the users, flexible. I want to represent this with two photos. I think that you can be aligned. You will have the automatic change and the manual change. I don't know who identifies OpenNebula with automatic. This that is with a low speed in changing things. We identified OpenNebula with the manual European solution. Why OpenNebula for CSUC? For us, two main things is to manage a modular private cloud that we have to offer our services, these application services, e-learning services, campus, virtual campus, and so on, and offer an open and integrated cloud service, public services, in a current federation in Spain. About some cords about our installation. Maybe it's similar from your case, where it uses typical virtualization infrastructure with host virtualization oriented, with this kind of different vendors, one hypervisor now with Ubuntu in our physical nodes, working nodes, the storage over, we are offering NFS over NetApp. Maybe it's the it's common in some presentations that we have seen the last OpenNebula conference, and in this way, we use OpenNebula switch over gigabit multi-provider vendor switches, different workload, e-learning platforms, VDI, HPC, individual VMs to cover some needs from our users, of our customers. Offering interfaces directly to our customers through Sandstone and some APIs to automate, you know, the authentication with or not with certificates and some templates with some operating systems. About the accounting, we have a special accounting that we combine the one OpenNebula reporting with a known development that inserts this data directly with to our ERP. About the architecture and the ecosystem of software that we are using here, we have the working part scale out with two zones here and connected to the commercial internet providers and to the research education network. From some different policies, we have some customers that can't not use research and education networks. We have to offer commercial providers to reach his services through internet. Okay, this is the tal. We have a multi-zone approach now in the same data center, but we want to change it because I think that this is a very extra value. About the infrastructure, I think that we are prepared to change and to squeeze the maximum this hardware that we have, that is available, and it's a cost, you know. About the hyper-threading, it's by default activated in your nodes. Depends. Depends of the workload. We have some benchmarks, and in the current workload that are offering transactional systems by for CSUC is activated by default. It provides more cores that can be used. Okay. In HPC clusters, this is another leak. Okay. About the CPU parameter. OpenNebula helps, differently for other cloud orchestrators or providers, to assign this parameter to a template. In our case, we are playing with the consolidation factor here. You know, when OpenNebula covers this factor, it not deploy a new virtual machine inside this host. And it's based about these CPU parameters. In our case, we have a compromise with our customers that we are provided this performance and the minimum with this CPU. These are not real values, okay? About the network level, network layer, we're using open UberSwitch that have some additional features, part of provide networking. It's about we have used OpenFlow to about security things, as you know, NetFlow about the monitoring part, and public addresses, quotes, ICLs by public network, QoS, etc. From the cloud user, the cloud admin that are using our platform, what are he saying about OpenUSwitch? They can provide in self-service new virtual private networks at level 2. They have can configure firewall config rules. We are in a DHCP-less environment, and we have an advanced monitoring capabilities in virtual machine layer. About the storage level layer, we use KUKO to images. We have compared aspects as the performance and basically the usage of disk. Okay. This always combined with a KUKO transfer driver and snapshotting. Okay. We're talking about non-persistent images. About the multi-zone environment. We believe in the multi-zone environment as provider. It offers a lot of possibilities for our customers. And our future is to have these two zones shared in two data centers. We are trying to, so we're searching funding for this. Now, and now, for our customer that are using this platform that it's now running, we offer Sandstone through VPN. Some APIs for cloud admins are available. Now, you know, they have an environment to manage his infrastructure and to build and to deploy applications and three layers and so on, complex applications, automate his deployment, etc. We have done this. All this information is in our corporate website with details, with a manual, with the form to contact and to contract these services. And all is packaged. But what about prices and costs? We have to be competitive. Not have sense if we are not competitive. And there are two main points that I want to comment. It's the consolidation factor that have to be aligned with the nodes that you are buying and the usage expectations. You have to be aligned with this scale out and to permit to scale out when you have customers, when you have to workload to put inside. In this case, we know we are not Amazon, we are not RestSpace, we are not we are a specific provider for a community that maybe we have 32 nodes, but the increase of these nodes have to be paid. Okay? And what is our approach about the prices and the costs? We are oriented to a predefined templates model. Yesterday, in the hack session, we discussed about this model and accounting. And I think with the show back option that is in the new release, in 3-4 months, no? Following the wave of OpenNebula releases, it can help us a lot to define prices per template. We have, this is very useful for us because our customers are choosing the template, are not choosing and configuring the machine. But if you have several templates, all can be inside. Okay, these are real prices by hour for each sentences, for each template. Now, this is offered with, about our experience, myths, and facts in this. Because that we have this service from January, March. And what we have seen here? We have seen some myths that I want to explain to you. One of these is the cloudification process. This is my board to come, I think, to travel to Milan last week. And it's, sorry, but it's in Spanish, but we have 3 steps to catch a flight. We can be aligned with cloudification here. Facturación here. You put your luggage, your data inside the cloud. Maybe it's the first step. Second step, security. I provide security to this data and all the compute that access to this data. And launch. Myth for cloudification. The real life here is that you have in our customers, we have to put something inside the cloud, maybe to cover some services, some public services, to provide file services, but that are not security or sensible, okay? And this is used now, our cloud, used to this some learning platforms, okay? But not the IRP of the university is provided directly of this to this platform. We have a private cloud that we are covering this, but we want to change. Another thing is the size. Does it matter? In our case, no. Okay, for our users, performance and security are very important here. It's a large infrastructure that we have to. You are one more. This is one of the feedback that we have. Okay, and the hypervisor is not relevant. Myth. Is relevant. Is still relevant. Because some services, but which is the hypervisor that you are using? VMware? KVM. Oh. Oh? Why? I don't know, but oh. It's okay. This is, you have to fight with these kind of things. OpenNebula can now manage this kind of hypervisors. And our strategy here as provider is that the customer, cloud admin here, wants to slice things, wants to slice. So the virtual data center approach is aligned to this, but it wants to slice in different size. Okay, it's not only all, for all the same equation. And that was another point is that always on. Is all these things to fight from the myths, to the myths. Always on, you know. Why you have to cloudify this? At home, in your own premise, is always on? Yes. You can change this. You can change this in some patterns. Maybe in an on-off pattern, maybe in a variable pattern aligned to concurrence, or in a, for instance, the same pattern. Maybe in our customers at university, you know, by night, why have you all on? You have a plan and you have a calendar. You can choose and redise. Some features that now OpenNebula is offering and you are offering to the customers. And the hybrid world. Just hybrid now, you have to be hybrid for your future, for this new model of management hardware. And it is, I know that we have, it is in our hands. Always on, one flow, one gate. Slice the carrot, BDC features. Just hybrid, but OpenNebula in their lives, in the lives of your customer. It's important. You have tech days, you have documentation. Why? But when they can build an hybrid from home and you are the provider. You and Amazon and Azure and IBM. Okay? And the receipt, go to the 4.28 or above version and be viral. Okay? And this is all. Danke. Thanks, gracias, gracias for your time, and I think it's time for questions.